Oh, look. Yep, there's another one. See, these clouds are dropping fast. They're spraying about 30,000 feet, 30 to 40,000 feet. That's where I saw them when I flew across country. So these guys are up there about 35,000 feet spraying. There's one. Here comes another one. They are busy today, man. I got to make up time. Yesterday they weren't flying because the winds were so strong after that storm. I got to make sure that that radiation that is would normally just blow over, you have to capture the radiation and bring it down out of the clouds if there's no moisture. Well, guess what barium does? Barium combines with the radioactive isotopes, clings to them like little bits of dust, and brings us straight down. Barium also turns the atmosphere into a plasma. That's a study you can find online, because they want you to know this stuff. They want smart people to know this stuff and either give up or get mad. Dumb people, they don't care. They don't want to find out. But barium turns the atmosphere into a plasma, and plasma superconducts electromagnetic waves and beams. And what does that mean? Well, they have systems now, and this is all on record, gigantic arrays of antenna that can beam billions of watts of energy, electromagnetic energy, up into the atmosphere. It actually pushes the atmosphere up, lifts the atmosphere, and when the atmosphere comes back down, guess what it does? It actually compresses the Earth's crust, unbelievably. When that happens, you get earthquakes.